Abe Noreman presents
Auti-HD Unscripted, but definitely edited.
Hello friends, I'm Alan Michael and welcome to Auti-HD Unscripted, where I monologue about what life is like as a person with both autism and ADHD, as well as whatever else is on my mind. My special interest is hip-hop beat making and production, along with a few other things, so if that sounds good to you, let's get started. Hello friends and welcome to Auti-HD Unscripted. I can't believe I'm doing this. I cannot believe I am doing this. But here I am.
You mean I have to live out the rest of my life in this body?
Anyway, this is going to be a completely unscripted show.
Because you're an abomination.
I want to get on here and talk about what life is like as an ADHD person with autism and ADHD, you see, or why I think the way I do, and it doesn't seem like anybody else thinks the way I do.
An outrage against nature!
Anyway, let's get to it. So, I think I had been questioning whether or not I was on the spectrum or not for a really long time, off and on. But most of the time, I would look up, and when I did suspect that I might be, I would go and look things up, and would find, you know, some information, and I could relate to some of it, but I couldn't relate to all of it. And I would think, nah, I'm not. Why am I even thinking of this? For what reason would I even be thinking about this?
You're turning human.
What?
The more time you spend in that body, the more human you become.
One day I had my YouTube on and I was driving for work, doing what I do. I don't remember the name of it exactly, but it was something about could it be autism and ADHD or something like that. And I watched this video, and as she started to describe the traits separately, and then describe them together and how they operate within her, having both ADHD and autism traits, and how they interact within your brain.
You got me into this. You get me out.
Well,
I can't do that.
Just felt as though she was describing me. I had like an epiphany.
What happened?
Oh, I saw the whole thing, dude. First you were all like, whoa, and then we were like, whoa, and then you were like, whoa.
What are you talking?
This is why this was just the most. I'm sitting in a car at work, and I'm realizing like, holy cow, this person is describing me.
Whoa! And then we were like, whoa!
This is exactly what I go through. So, anyway, from there, I found a whole bunch of autistic creators who go online and talk about autism and ADHD or Auti-HD. And I can mention I'm a huge fan of some shows. I enjoy Woodshed Theory quite a bit, and I also like what's the other one? Autistomatic, and Paul Life. I can't remember the name of his channel either. But
I thought something like this might happen. That's why I prepared for it.
I can probably put links to their channels in my description. And I, as you may notice, this is not a video podcast.
Duh.
Excuse me? No, duh is a product of fear.
So that's basically how I figured it out. And I ran it past my wife, and she told me that she also had been thinking that I was on the spectrum as well, which would explain a lot of social things in my life. And then I started having this feeling like this was something I wanted to do, like those guys. But then I thought, no, I don't want to do what everybody, all these other people are doing. I'm just copying other people. And why do I want to do this in the first place? Why would I want to do a podcast? But here's the thing. I am very much into my special interest, I suppose. It's my special interest is music. Making music.
Oh, come here, you big dumb
dummy head!
I've been doing it since I was about 16, maybe even younger. I've been doing that for a really long time, and I started with just a couple tape decks, and hopefully in later episodes, maybe I'll talk more about that, and maybe you'll get to know me more as I do more episodes. I'm just trying to give you all a quick introduction as to who I am and what the purpose of this podcast would be. And I really don't have that defined yet. I don't have it defined. What I was thinking of doing was something unscripted, which is what I'm thinking of titling this, is Auti-HD Unscripted. And I thought I would just, whenever I can, get on the microphone and produce a podcast episode and talk about different aspects of things going on in my life and share my experiences with others. I think on some level I'm thinking that this is going to be therapeutic for me, because then I'll get to talk about this. And that's one of the hard... Because it is something that I've wanted to talk about. I want to talk about it a lot. But unfortunately, I really can't. It's the reason why...
Who did this?
The reason for that is, I can, but I feel like nobody cares. just be real, nobody cares.
Nobody really cares anymore?
Nobody cares. That's what it is. It's just nobody gives a shit. I've tried, I can talk about it a little bit, but I can't dive deep and then the other problem is that it'll be about me, and I already have that problem where for the longest time I thought I was narcissistic, and I want to go, I'll delve into all these different things that I've dealt with and hopefully maybe get some clarity, and maybe find community, and maybe find friends. Maybe I won't feel so lonely.
Loneliness has followed me my whole life. Everywhere. Bars and cars, sidewalks, stores, everywhere. There's no escape. God's a lonely man.
I am not lonely in the sense that I have a family, and but I don't have a lot of friends. This feels so odd to say, but I don't really have any friends. I have friends, but I guess when I think of having friends, I think of, people that you see on a regular basis and you hang out with and you gel with and you feel like you're on the same page maybe with someone, or you share experiences with someone and...
This is crazy.
I know. It doesn't make any sense. That's why I trusted.
I don't know if I can sit here and try to explain what I'm trying to say here, but I really just don't feel like I have friends, and I need some place to go and talk, and I can't afford therapy, and it's not only that I can't afford therapy,
and I tell you that shock therapy is too strong for him in his present state,
but it's also that I don't have time. My life requires, my life circumstances require me to be on game all the time. I need to go to work. I come home. I cook dinner. I gotta pay my bills. I gotta pay the bills. I gotta take care of my kids. I gotta,
Listen, Roach. I don't want any excuses out of you, hear me?
Do a lot of stuff. And try to make time for special interests too. Hey, it just feels like there isn't enough time, and I can't even imagine adding one more thing to that. This I could do. This I can do, because I can do it whenever I want. With a therapy sessions, I could probably use something like BetterHelp. I just paused on that because I was thinking about all the people I heard that have sponsorships with BetterHelp on YouTube. Maybe I'll be promoting them too. Maybe they'll give me some deals. I don't know. I need therapy. I need someone to talk to. So I figure if I do it this way, I go on YouTube and I could talk about me, my experiences, and hopefully maybe help someone else either have their own realizations, or maybe somebody who's struggling with their traits will have somebody they can listen to and relate to, because I know that there are people that I listen to and relate to. And even when they're talking about things that I feel like I already know now, I still listen to the autistic creators on YouTube, because that feels like my community. They feel like they are my community. I feel like part of that, even though I'm watching from a distance. You know, I don't comment on the videos that I watch. I just enjoy listening to someone who can talk about things that I can relate to. And so I'm just hoping that doing something like this will provide something for somebody. I don't even know. I feel like it's, and some on some level, it also feels like it's completely pointless what I'm doing.
So let's just stop gabbing on about it. It's completely pointless, and it's getting us nowhere.
Right. I agree. This is a complete waste of time.
What am I doing here? What am I doing here? What am I doing here? Oh, Lord. Have mercy on me. All right, well, I'm going to keep going, because I got the time, I got the space, and all I could think about today was doing this, because I just felt so like, yeah, this is it. This is what I want to do. I can do a show. I can host my own podcast and talk about things that I want to talk about, and talk about my special interests, and just have a platform or a place to go to do it. And this seems like the place to go and do it.
You sly dog! You got me monologuing! I can't believe
it. So I recently went out and bought some vinyl records. I have a record player. I don't have the professional like turntables for DJing or anything like that. Just a record player. It's kind of fun to just, I don't know why I do it. I like the nostalgia of picking up an old vinyl record and digging the crates for samples. And I recently found, I went out and picked up a Lionel Richie record. The one that I did recently, I've done two tracks. But the one I'm going to play today is one where I sampled Runnin' with the Night by Lionel Richie. And I hope that you'll listen to it, and maybe you can let me know what you think. Yeah, that's pretty much all I got today, but we'll keep moving forward with Auti-HD Unscripted. And thank you everybody for listening. Please like and subscribe if you feel like it, and I'll catch you on the next one. Good night, everybody.